Hello children. So today in this module we are going to read the story The Enemy by Pearl S. Buck, who was an American author. Now she was born in 1892 and she was also called a third culture kid because though she was born in America, but she was born in a family of missionaries. So she kept moving from America to China, and then for some time she was even in Japan. Fine. So that is why, because she was, you know, nurtured, or she grew up in the midst of various or variety of cultures. So that is why she was called third culture kid by critics or by several sociologists also. Most of her work contains international or intercultural themes, you know, because the way she was nurtured, the atmosphere she grew up in, it all affected her writing also. So it left its impression on that. Now in 1938, Buck received the Nobel Prize for Literature. Now children, I must tell you that she was the first American woman to receive this honor. And though she received this honor, but she had to face a lot of criticism from the authors like William Faulkner and Robert Frost. I don't know whether you know about William Faulkner, but you must be knowing about Robert Frost, find the famous poet. Okay, and Robert Frost, even, you know, he went to this extreme to say that if she can achieve it, then anybody can achieve it. Fine. Means if she did it, then anybody could do it. Okay, so she had to face a lot of criticism when she, you know, won this Nobel Prize for Literature. So children, Pearl S. Buck lived through the Boxer Rebellion in 1900. Now before moving on, I would suggest that you read about Boxer Rebellion, which took place in 1900, and also that Nanking incident, which I told you earlier while I was telling you about the author. And if you would read about both the incidents, you would also get to know that how not only this story The Enemy, which Pearl has written, but many other, you know, her novels and her literary work, it was affected by what she experienced there in China. And how when she went to Japan, you know, for a year, though that was a very short time when she had to, you know, live in Japan, but whatever she experienced there, a glimpse of that we can also, you know, see there in The Enemy, that made her, you know, create these two characters, Hannah and Sadao, who are the lead characters or who are the protagonists of her story. Well, moving on with this author. So what happened in Boxer Rebellion, that there was a group of staunchy anti-imperialist peasants that brutally killed 230 foreigners, were mostly Christian missionaries and several thousand Chinese Christians. I must tell you children that this writer also belonged to the family of missionaries. That is why she kept moving from America to China and then to Japan and then again back to America. Okay, the 8-year-old Buck and her family escaped to Shanghai and then returned briefly to the United States. This experience of being rejected, hated, and at risk of being killed because of her race, religion, and nationality deeply impacted the young Pearl S. Buck. And the same experience resonates throughout her literary works, including The Enemy, and is seen most clearly by the way she stresses the universality of humankind, which is muddled by nationalism and racial prejudice. So I hope you must have got an idea that in the story, The Enemy also, this, you know, universal brotherhood, the theme of universal brotherhood and nationalism, it's been, you know, muddled. There's this conflict between the two being shown in the story. The Enemy, which was published a year after the attack on Pearl Harbor in 1941, this event catalyzed America's entry into World War II, which is when The Enemy is set. So here I have not only given you the background of the author and how her writing was impacted by whatever she experienced in her life, but also I have set here the background of the story, The Enemy, that we are going to read now. Now, setting of the story. So time the story takes place during the Second World War, when Japan and America are at war with each other. That is early 1940s. That is the time of the story. Place is the story set on the Japanese coast in the home of Dr. Sadao Hoki. Mood. The mood is reflected in the natural weather conditions, which underline the changing and often conflicting emotions of the main characters. At first, the weather is foggy and misty, signifying the dilemma that Sadao and his wife face when they find the American soldier, the war prisoner. The weather is windy in the midsection, symbolizing the tension in Sadao's thoughts. And in the end, the rain is the natural outcome of the fog and mist in the beginning and symbolizes reconciliation. Plot. The plot is woven through a number of stages that lead to the climax of the story, after which the speed of the story it decreases, until finally all the elements are drawn together in the conclusion. The stages of the plot are: the first one is serenity. The scene described at the beginning of the story is one of tranquility and serenity. Hannah, the wife of Dr. Sadao, she comes out to her husband and affectionately holds his arm. Together they make a picture of perfect harmony. This picture of a happy, loving couple is soon shattered by the emergence of a body at the coast covered with mist. Dilemma. This is the second step of the story. The arrival of the wounded white soldier disturbs the happy family picture. Sadao and his wife must make a choice now. Treat the man or let him die. Give him shelter or throw him back into the sea. Turn him into the authorities or let him recover first. As a doctor, Sadao is sworn to help any man in need. But this man is his enemy. If he turns the man over to the police, he will surely die. But if Sadao shelters him in his home, he himself could be condemned as a traitor. This conflict with no satisfactory solution is a dilemma. Finally, they decide to bring him inside, and after he has regained his strength, to turn him over to the authorities. Third is complications. The placid everyday life of the household is disrupted. Sadao discovers that he must operate on the soldier in order to save his life. But no one is willing to help him. The very idea of touching a white man is repulsive, as Japanese thought that they belong to, you know, Japanese belong to a high race. Hannah, the wife of Sadao, finally consents to help him operate. But none of the servants can even try to understand the conflicting feelings within Sadao as a doctor and Sadao as a citizen of Japan. Now the next step is crisis. The crisis comes when the servants leave the house. Since they are superstitious and uneducated, they cannot fathom Sadao's reasons for saving the soldier's life. They look at the world in black and white and cannot understand anything in between. Once they leave, the burden of running the household falls on Hannah, who proves to be an understanding and reliable wife to Sadao. Together, they cope with the operation and with keeping the house in order, and the soldier recovers. Now, the main question has to be faced. Will Sadao inform the police after saving the man's life? Then climax. The conflict comes to a head during the operation, and when it is over, Sadao starts to write the report to the police, but never sends it. Now Sadao rather shares this information personally to the army general. With this act, he has kept his promise to his wife and performed his duty to his country. Now tension rises. Will General Takima arrest him? The general can understand Sadao's behavior since he also studied in America. Moreover, he needs Sadao to take care of him and treat his illness. The general suggests an easy solution to the doctor's problem by offering to send his assassins to kill Tom, thus removing from Sadao the burden of making a decision. The doctor suffers through three long windy nights, but the assassins do not appear. And finally, resolution. Sadao is unable to sleep and cannot keep his secret from Hannah. He is forced to act, so he helps Tom escape. With the soldier's departure, the conflict is resolved He feels he has done his duty to his country and also kept faith with his profession. Tranquility is restored to the house. Now, this was the plot of the story, children. Now, let's check analysis of the story. Let's analyze it a bit. So, the story is set in Japan during the Second World War. Japan was at war with the United States. Japanese aggression and hatred against all other races had been intensifying and impressed so deeply into the minds of the citizens of Japan that it was part of their culture. Chauvinism was at its height then. Thus, the story revolves around the theme of racial superiority and Japanese chauvinism. And to contrast to this theme, we have Dr. Sadao and Hana, who are yet not much affected by the trend of hating other countrymen and considering them as their enemy. Thus, the presence of Dr. Sadao and Hana make us perceive that the main idea of the story is the inner conflict, which actually reflects the bigger conflict, which is his devotion to his profession or Dr. Sadao's loyalty to his country. On one hand, since Japan is at war, harboring an enemy is treason. While to make Sadao believe that nationalism is far superior to any other quality is his whole background, his upbringing in a chauvinistic society, his strong nationalism, and the tremendous influence of his father should be enough for Sadao to choose nation over anything else. On the other hand, he had received a modern education abroad. Dr. Sadao had studied medicine and knew very well the principles of humanitarianism. In other words, it was his duty as a doctor to operate on the wounded man, regardless of his nationality or race. These are conflicting loyalties, or the conflict between two words, between tradition and modern education. And this conflict has been beautifully explored through the character of Dr. Sadao and General Takema. Now, the message that the story conveys. The real conflict here is between the humanitarian values instilled in Sadao during his years of study in America and the age-old heritage of racial superiority and prejudice he grew up with and lives with daily in Japan. The conflict is resolved when humanitarianism overcomes prejudice and chauvinism, which is the message the story conveys to the readers. Now, children, summary to help you out in understanding the chapter in a better manner. The Enemy is a story written by Pearl S. Buck, published in November 1942 and narrated in third person. Why third person? Because third person is like omnipresent and omniscient. Fine. So, it is about a Japanese surgeon, Sadao, who goes to study in America and meets a Japanese girl, Hana, there. He marries her when he's sure that she belongs to the same race. As Sadao's father is a strict traditional Japanese. Later, they both come back to Japan to settle down happily. Now, the story shifts to the time of World War II. Thus, all the doctors are called upon to serve the Japanese army and they're moving with the troop. However, they allow Sadao to stay back as he is the finest surgeon in Japan and is tending to the old general who is on his deathbed. However, one night, an incident changes his life. He encounters an American Navy man who is injured by a gunshot and dying. Although Sadao is in no mood to help the enemy, he takes in the young soldier and provides him with medical assistance. He keeps him at his house to avert any danger coming his way. However, he knows that he has opened doors to danger by helping the enemy. His servants decide to leave Sadao too. As the days keep passing, the soldier is now beginning to gain his health back. Now that the soldier is no longer Sadao's patient, so Sadao no longer feels responsible for him. and he feels that his duty as a doctor was over. Thus, he informs the general about the American, and thus the general reciprocates. They decide to send private assassins to kill the American soldier. While waiting for the assassins, Sadao starts noticing that it was delaying. However, during this course, humanity in Sadao awakes. He realizes that he is a human being. At the end of the day, he now recognizes the value of human life as well as universal brotherhood. Thus, this opens his mind, which was limited to race, boundaries and wars. Finally, he comes to the conclusion that the American soldier is not his enemy, just because he belongs to another country. Thus, he rises above his prejudices and does the right thing by helping the American soldier escape, thus saving his life. So the story tells us how love and compassion can make us better human beings as opposed to prejudices and biases against other people with whom we do not share anything but the bond of being humans. Now, there are certain key facts about the story. You can check all those here, like what was the time and which time the story is set, the place where the story was written, it was published in which year, literary period, genre, setting, climax, antagonist, narration. So these are the key facts that you must know about the story, and it's given in short here. I hope you all must have understood the story. In case of any queries, I'll be happy to help you. Please send it to me. Stay home, stay safe, and take care of yourself.